Hello, welcome to the first official JYJ repair video. My name is Jeff and this is my channel. I've been wanting to do stuff like this for a little while. I've always been really big into fixing things, finding broken things and getting them to work again. It just fascinates me. And of course, in the long run, that saves more room in our landfills and stuff like that. So just sit back and relax and hope you enjoy the video. Today we are going to be working on my Xbox Series Elite 2. I dropped my controller last week, coincidentally the day before the new Modern Warfare came out, and this right click button doesn't work anymore. You see here, this one works, you can hear that clicking in there. This one doesn't really make any sound. So we're going to get this apart. Just a little disclaimer, I am not a professional, nor do I know everything that I'm doing. I've just watched a lot of YouTube videos, and I'm just putting it to work myself. So, watch this video with caution if you're planning on doing your own repair like this. And let's get started. Alright, first we're going to be taking these joystick thumb things off. Set this one to the side here. Now, I've had this one open before, so I've actually replaced this right bumper button here. And that actually went pretty well, so this case is going to come off, this top cover is going to come off a lot easier for me than it probably will for somebody that hasn't had theirs open before. So just be a little careful, you don't want to snap the tabs in there and not be able to get it back on. So I'm going to take my pry tool and I'm just going to go right in here. Must have snapped this one down really good because it's not popping off as easy as it used to. There we go. All right, we got that top cover off now. It's been a while since I've done this, so I know the first thing we have to do is take these joysticks off. I use this one, just pop it on there. They actually screw on there, which is a pretty cool feature. Set those to the side. Let's see if I can zoom in here for you guys. You look here, push on this one. Damn, I gotta cut my fingernails, it's gross. You see that I'm pushing that button there. Look at that plastic piece right there. We're going over here, push on this one. That thing just moves, you can kind of see it wiggling around in there. I go over the side here. That little plastic piece down here is broken. All right, let's see where we gotta go with this. I think we pop this part off next. I actually cracked mine the first time I did this, so be careful with this part. It kind of sucks. I think I'm just gonna order a new one and hopefully pop it in there. I was thinking about buying a bunch of these broken ones on eBay and trying to fix those, but like I said, I'm not a professional, so I don't want to spend a bunch of money until I know exactly what I'm doing. And I think these just, they like spring in there somehow. I'm really scared of breaking this. I don't want to fucking break it. Let's get this last piece off of there. So our main goal is we gotta get this stuff out here, and then we gotta get this. I think it's one board that have all these on it, or that have the joysticks on it. I don't remember. Looks like there's a tab right in here. Let's just let's take out these screws real quick and see if that helps us at all. I doubt it, but. These are security bits, so we got the T9 security bit. Take these out quick so they don't fall off and lose them or something. Two here. That one used to have a security sticker on it. Like I said, I had this open before and I changed that bumper. And I think I've dropped this thing so many times that sometimes for a while there these wouldn't click. And then I had to open it up and try to figure out what was going on there. But I think it was mostly because I didn't have this cover snapped down good enough. They're really nice controllers, but if you have hardwood floors, the hardwood floors kind of win that battle. Alright, awesome. That's a lot easier than I thought. This whole thing comes out here. Oh, you can see the soldering job I did there. That looks... All right, let's see here. I wonder how we can get this board out. Please. Take these out, and this just pops out of there. Alright, got my tweezers here. We gotta take off these, I think these are for the antennas, or just connections. Wires go all the way up around here and go into that board. I really don't want to unsolder all this. I also don't want to fuck anything up on that board while I'm trying to move shit around. Sick. I already broke one of the motors off. Nice. I guess we're just gonna unsolder it all anyway. All right. Okay. Let's take this one off. Okay, we got those off. Now we just got the board, which just looks a lot easier to work with all that extra shit on there. So it looks like 6, 7. So we've got to undo all of these so we can get this whole analog stick out of there. I got one in the mail from iFixit. There's a product number if you want to use it. It was kind of cool because I thought this whole button system here was separate, but it looks like it's the whole joystick. So we gotta figure out, are we just gonna unsolder these one by one and kind of pull on it, or are we just gonna get the hot air out? I think the hot air would probably be the best. Let's just do the hot air. And then we'll clean up this board too. Looks like I still got some leftover. Could be flux or something. Or they could be just water, because it looks like it's kind of like corrosion or something like that. Alright, I'll get the hot air station set up, get that heating up, and then we'll throw some flux on there and then get the joystick out. Alright, I got the hot air station going. It looks ghetto, but I put some Capcom tape to kind of protect this stuff over here, because I guarantee I'll probably knock something off or ruin it or something like that. We're gonna throw some flux on this and then see if we can't get that out of there. Just like I thought, I'd knock the fucking component off right over there. Damn it. Alright. I'm gonna stop for a minute. Alright. I got that component back on. To this date, that's probably the smallest component I've ever changed or put back. Hopefully it's in the right direction. I guess we'll find out. It kind of looks like shit. Whatever, it's on there right now. Let's get the last few legs out of here. Okay, let's try the heat gun again. And let's try not to knock anything off the fucking board again too. Alright, finally, holy snikes. We got that last piece out. Should be hot. Looks like we got, I didn't knock anything else off. We just gotta clean up those solder holes so we can get the new one in. Oh shit, I did knock another component off. Basically this one right here. Let's get that back on, and then hopefully we won't have any more fuck-ups. At this point, I'll be surprised if I can get this working, or if this works again after I'm done. But it's probably a good video for you guys to watch and then see what not to do. Here's our new one. See if we can't at least get it started. Yeah, we gotta get that solder out of there. Let's do that and we'll clean up the board. Jeez, look at that. I just knocked that chip off again. Fuck! Are you serious? Oh my god. Alright, we're gonna set that there. Just a minute. I'll probably turn my airspeed down to like 6. Oh my god. If I keep doing that, I'm gonna have to rebuild this entire board. It'd be a good experience, but. That was a huge fucking pain in the ass. I don't know if you'll be able to see it, but I knocked this one off again. That looks like shit. I'll have to clean that up. And then I knocked this right here, this DB14 off. Pretty sure that's where it goes. I looked up the board online. I hope there's nothing else that I'm missing. I guess we'll find out when we try to put it back together, I guess. But let's just get this new joystick in and get it back together. We gotta clean it up first. Alright, just to clean this up, I'm gonna use some isopropyl alcohol or rubbing alcohol, whatever you wanna call it. See if we can get this seated in here. It's gonna go like that. Still got some solder left in the holes. Two of those. I really don't want to put that hot air on this again because the last few times I did that, I keep knocking shit off. So let's see what we can do. This one that's causing a problem. There you go. All right. Got that in there, nice and flush. Now we just have to resolder these legs here. Let's put a little more flux. That'll help the solder flow. Just like the Tronix Fix likes to say. Thank you. So we got that in. What do we gotta do next? We gotta remember where these go. And then we gotta get these motors back in too. Let's just try to slide this board in. Got that in there. Then it clips into the bottom board. I think these went in here. Yep. Trying to be careful there because that wire looked like it wasn't too healthy. Alright, so the hard part's over. Maybe. We gotta get these wire sider back on. And I don't really remember where they went. I'm gonna take a quick Google search and look. See where these all these wires go, just so we don't screw it up. Alright, I found some videos. Not some videos, but a picture of where these wires go. Coincidentally, is on iFixit.com. So it says the gray one goes to SQ1. SO1. All right, let's do the other side. Black one goes to the bottom. All I needed was some flux. Just further proof that I am an idiot. Yeah, I think that's everything. We just gotta put it back together. How do we do that? No idea. Why isn't that clicking like it's supposed to? Dude, did I change the wrong one? Wow, I'm a fucking idiot. Changed the wrong joystick. Alright, whatever. We're still gonna put it back together and see if the one that I changed did work right. I don't know. I'm kind of upset I did that. Well, either way, we're gonna put it back together. And then we'll go test it. And then I'll probably order another fucking stick and do the correct one this time. Because we broke this one getting it out. And I'm not putting that back in here. I don't think it'll work anyway. It might. But I'm pretty sure there's something missing there. And this thing doesn't even want to move correctly. I feel really stupid. Alright, I got everything back together. Let's go try test it and see at least if the left stick works since I replaced that one. Alright, well, we got. Turns on. Still connects. Oh, the left stick's working. Let's go to. Gamepad tester. Where is it? There it is. Alright. You see? There's no stick drift. The button works. This one works. But the button doesn't work there. Changed the wrong joystick like a freaking idiot. Back buttons for the paddle buttons still work. That works. Okay, so basically I fixed it to back where it was before, but at least I know that everything works. And I didn't lose any components, any other components that may have not been able to be seen or anything like that. So I guess I'm not terribly mad. I've never done that before. I've also never replaced or put small components back on. Please excuse my kids. They're loud and they will not listen. So we got everything working. Maybe I'll do a follow-up video once I put the new stick on, the correct one. Thanks for watching. And if you guys like the video, just leave me a comment. Like, share, subscribe. All of that will be appreciated. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.